That's what I said. Grind it out. They did.
For game three, it's time for the clutch performance of the night, presented by Bridgestone. 35 stops by Tuukka Rask. Weeksy, he's doing the same thing all postseason long.
Yeah, he totally is. He's locked in. There's no wasted motion with Tuukka Rask either. I love his reads. When it's time to slide, he slides. When it's time to stay locked in and be positionally, he's positionally sound. When it's time to improvise the way he does there, a la Byron Defoe, with an old-school two-pad stack, he does that as well. But the first period, as Rupper said, it was a wrap. You know why it was a wrap? Tuukka made 20 saves on 20 shots. The Bees were outshot. To the credit of the Canes, they came out, played their game plan. They outshot them 20-6 in the first period. Courtesy of our statistician, Jonathan Barron, upstairs, they had 35 attempts, did the Canes, in that first period. And Tuukka snuffed everything out, having making 20 saves in that period. That was the game, Rupper, as you pointed out.
You heard Rask say there in the post-game interview that when you have a guy like him, that he's swallowing up these pucks. And if the puck squirts free for a rebound, he's getting real good effort by his defenseman to clear bodies out, clear pucks out. So there's no second chance opportunities, I should say, for the Carolina Hurricanes. And that's huge, because when you know that your goaltender's stopping all the first shots and you're cleaning up the second shots, you ain't going to be scoring any goals if you're the opponent. So that's something that they've done a real good job with.
And one thing, too, for me and the Canes, I think, going forward, they got the shot attempts that they wanted. They had the offensive zone time. But one adjustment that I think that they can make, they're around Tuukka, but they're not really fully in front of Tuukka. Now, listen, we know you're Jack and you're a big man. We'll get you guys both on camera, but watch this sequence. Now, they're around him, but he's able to still see it. And when you've got a guy that's the all-time franchise winner for games in the Boston Bruins history, something tells me, no, that's a good moving screen, but he still ended up catching that clean. Look at this one. Yeah. He absorbs that, Rupper, to your point, right in the breadbasket, no rebound. So listen, Bronny, you're jacked, because we know you're already a big man.
Not me.
You're a big man at 6'29", or whatever you are, 6'10", or whatever it is.
But in your grill.
But yeah, like, I can see pucks. Tuukka's 6'4", I'm 6'1". I can see pucks. Now, if you guys are actually in front of me, now this
are
is
we doing this?
We're doing this on live TV.
Scotty's got you taking the eyes away.
Okay,
from you.
This is a different thing. You're supposed to. Played with Dino Cicerelli. I played with Dave Andrechuk. Those are two of the best net front guys, and Thomas Holmstrom, I didn't play with, unfortunately, played against. Those are two of the best, three of the best net front guys in the history of the game. They played goalie in front of the opposing goalie. And I think that Carolina's in and around them, but they're not really in front of them, Rupp.
When I played for Torts, and anybody that's any former player that hears this that plays for has played for Torts knows that he says this all the time. He always says, "You're there, but you're not." And I didn't really understand what that meant all the time when he would say it. But it's one of those things that your intentions are right. You're there, but you're not really there. You're not accomplishing what you're going for. And so they're going to the net, and that's what you're supposed to do. But they're there, but they're not. They're not taking the eyes away. They're not making it hard on Tuukka. Tuukka, if he sees the puck, just like any goalie that gets hot this time of year, and this guy is Conn Smythe worthy right now, if he sees it, he will stop it flat out. If he sees it, he's going to stop it. You got to find a way, make him uncomfortable, take his eyes away, make him look around, look up, look down, look around you. He has to fight the screen. Right now, they're there, but they're not. They're not making him fight through it enough.
Exactly. And when you're fighting those screens, that's the lactic acid building up in the quads and the hammies and the calves and the foot muscles. You know what I mean? Like, you're exerting so much more energy as a goalie when you've got to fight. You're up, you're down, you're around. You're trying to look under, you're trying to look over. You exert so much more energy. But if you can just get to the spot, stop, your D are boxing out, as he's giving their D a lot of credit. He gets a clean line of sight. Cool. All right, Cherries, let's go. Here, take that. No problem. Face off.
We do a lot of great demos here. That one's up there. That one's up there.
Seriously.
Bridgestone tires are built to come through in the clutch, just like NHL players.